بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عبده المصطفى وعلى آله ومن بهدي اقتفى على آله وصحبه ومن بهدي اقتفى وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. This is just another quick video inshallah ta'ala responding to the lies and deception of a donkey of Birmingham. The donkey of Birmingham is sufficient for me to call him a donkey of Birmingham, as I've mentioned the reason being because كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفار, like a donkey carrying a books. And he mentioned that he's a layman. If you are a layman, ya ayyuha donkey, why you are opening big books and translating them to the layman like you without referring back to ahl al-ilm, to the scholars? As you know, in kunta la ta'lamu fatilka musibatun wa in kunta ta'lamu fal musibatu a'zamu, that those books is not the books that you open them up for the layman, but because you're a layman, that's a calamity. You don't understand the books, the al-mutawwalat, that should not be taught to the layman. But you are كَمَثَلُ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُ أَسْفَارًا, donkey kind of books. And you are the person who Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan, may Allah preserve him, mentioned in his kitab, that also of the books explaining that one of the ulama mentioned the reason the society get destroyed. There's three types of people that destroy societies. Okay? One of them destroys someone's tongue, the one who's half Nahwi. One of them is half faqih. You know, he hasn't even studied yet. He started bringing the books, mutawwalat, teaching the layman. He himself does not understand what he's reading. He does not understand what he's reading. So he mentioned that, well, last time a brother was asking me questions about, there's some ulama, as I have mentioned from the beginning, by this deceitful person who's playing around. He said, yeah, but look, there's some ulama. My brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. If you go to the mutawwalat of kutub al-fiqh, you come across some things, you'll be very surprised. You know, you'll be very surprised. So does it mean because some ulama said it, khalas yakfi? Because we have hadith of Nabi alayhi salatu salam. So not if a scholar said something and the other scholar said something and get the opposite, then what we do, we go to those who follow the hadith, who has the proofs. Okay? So he said about the hadith of when Prophet Sallam, he said, I'm misquote. He miskin, this guy. He doesn't understand what is misquote or mixed up. So because I was mentioned a hadith, so I mentioned two hadith and put them together. Nah? But all of them are the same meaning. That you still hear and obey the Muslim leaders. Even if they do something which you are displeased with. Even if you hate what they're doing. Okay? You hate it, yes. But that should not be justification for you to rebel against them. Who said that? Not Shamsi. The Messenger Sallam. So those who are listening to Hajji, on the Day of Judgment, you have Muhammad alayhi salatu salam, and you have a donkey here. Prophet Sallam said something completely different than a donkey. But donkey, he reminds me of, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, about the people of Thamud, أَحَبُّ الْعَمَى عَلَى الْهُدَى. They prefer blindness over guidance. So now, yes, sometimes we don't know everything, but if someone brings you the proofs, don't say to him, Alim said this, Alim said that. Because a donkey of Birmingham, it reminds me of, there was a teacher, he used to teach in the mosque. So he wants to travel, and there's no one to teach the people. So he left his son. He said, any question they ask you, say what? اختلف العلماء. The ulama differ. There's different opinions. That's what Donkey of Birmingham doing. اختلف العلماء. So this, his son, every time they ask him questions, اختلف العلماء. There's different opinions. One of the people noticed that this person doesn't know. That's why he keeps saying اختلف. So he said, أفي الله شك. Is there, Sheikh, is there any doubt about Allah? He said, اختلف العلماء. So they know he's jail, he's just repeating something, اختلف العلماء. So that's this donkey of Birmingham. Everything, there's different opinions. No. The hadith, النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. We follow المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام. We don't follow Abu Hanifa blindly, Ahmed ibn Hanbal blindly, Shafi'i blindly, Malik al-Awza'i blindly. No, we follow المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام blindly. Meaning we follow what he said عليه الصلاة والسلام. Without question it, because he was as-sadiq al-masduq alayhi salatu wa salam. Anyway, the hadith is here, Sahih Muslim, here Donkey of Birmingham. The hadith is Sahih Muslim. You should, if you're an honest person, you say, yeah, maybe the brother, it's happened to everyone, sometimes you mix one hadith to another hadith, but his point is making, there is a proof for it. Now, let us read the hadith. I want you, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. Likewise, those who are heavily affected by this khuruj, what do you think about this hadith? Are you going to follow Prophet Sallam or are you going to follow desires? Listen to this hadith. This hadith, you'll break your back. Especially those who are stubborn, upon misguidance. The Messenger of Allah mentioned, which is Hadith Awf ibn Malik, Sahih Muslim. Okay. Al-Ashja'i. يقول سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول خيار أئمتكم الذين تحبونهم ويحبونكم وتصلون عليهم ويصلون عليكم وشرار أئمتكم الذين تبغضونهم ويبغضونكم وتلعنونهم ويلعنونكم قالوا قلنا يا رسول الله قلنا يا رسول الله أفلا ننابذهم عند ذلك قال لا ما أقام فيكم الصلاة أوكي ألا من ولي عليه وال فرآه يأتي شيئا من معصية الله فليكره ما يأتي من معصية الله ولا ينزعا يدا من طاعة وسلم. So let us translate. Prophet ﷺ said, the best of your leaders, those who make dua for you, those who love them and they love you, and those who you make dua, they make dua for you and you make dua for them. And the most evil of your leaders, those who hate you and you hate them. Okay? Washirar, they're not good leaders, evil leaders. They hate you and you hate them. They curse you and you curse them. So the Sahaba said, should we not fight them? Afala nunabiduhum? Okay? I believe even another narration, which is, ala nuqatiluhum, there's another narration. Okay? Should I not fight them? He said, لا ما أقاموا فيكم الصلاة. No, as long they establish the prayer. Okay, as long they establish the prayer twice. Then he said, if anyone has a leader of in charge of him, and he sees something which he hates, okay, like ma'asiyah, disobedience, then فليكره ما يأتي من ma'asiyah. Let him hate the ma'asiyah. But do not rebel. فلا تنزع يدنا من طاعة. That's the hadith of the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام. So my question to you, now let us, why are you going to do with this hadith? For Salim said, you're going to hate, they're going to be evil. They're going to curse you and you're going to curse them. Of you, of course, you're going to curse someone that you love. They're going to be evil. For Salim didn't say, rebel against them. Okay, for Salim did not rebel, said, and now he mentioned, he said, as long as they establish the prayer, preserve the salawat. Okay, and even the other narration, as you have mentioned, says, should I not fight them, ala nuqatiluhum, la ma sallu, as long they pray, okay? And here he said even about, inshallah, I'll bring another one, another video, because I just want to make this video about his deception. They saw this hadith, and inshallah, as I mentioned, I promise, brothers and sisters, there will be a video, inshallah ta'ala, the brothers show me, video, one of the ulama mentioned, there's 100 hadith, shows you 100 hadith, warning against rebellion against the Muslim leaders. 100 hadith. Okay? And it's going to take us time, inshallah ta'ala. But the point here is, like when the brother asked me, yes, there is some ulama and Ibn Taymiyyah wrote a book called Raf al-Malam an Immat al-A'lam, removing the blame from the scholars. Sometimes scholar doesn't know the hadith. Sometimes, like Ibn Khattab, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَنَ الْفَارُوقِ أَبُو حَفْصٍ رضي الله عنه. The story is known. Ammar ibn Yasir of Tayammum. Umar didn't know about the Tayammum. Ammar ibn Yasir reminded him of this, when he was traveling with the Messenger of Sallam. So sometimes some Sahaba didn't know some ahkam because, you know, some Sahaba heard the hadith. The Sahaba didn't hear the hadith. It was ma'roof amongst, let alone the ulama who came after. So we say, yeah, the ulama upon Sunnah striving, but they made a mistake here. Don't say, اختلف العلماء. As a leeway for your deviation and misguidance. Okay? So if you are a layman, my advice to you, close the books, shut down your TV, and go sleep. Because a layman, and as a Muslim, because you are a layman, I'm me. Me, alhamdulillah, I studied. I study enough to know that the scholars mentioned, mutawwalat, you don't open mutawwalat to the layman people. Because there's many ikhtilafat, there's a way to study. But when you have a donkey of Birmingham opening mutawwalat, causing confusion amongst the shabab, when he himself admits as a layman, so you should not do that. Naam, I agree, there's different types of layman, without any doubt. Naam, there's different types of layman. But you are the worst layman. Jahil layman. The proof of that, There is no scholars who will tell you to open a mutawwalat and to translate them for the layman people without understanding. No, you start from the beginning. Okay, may Allah bless you, my brothers and sisters. Then, to go back to the main point, what do you think about this hadith? Oh, those who blind follow him. Are you for Prophet Muhammad? Be specific. Or are you going to follow the donkey? سبحانك الله بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وسلم تسليما كثيرا